Greetings, greetings, greetings. Back to Nature Africa. Back to Nature community. Back to Nature family. All out there in the YouTube land, the internets. Welcome to another fantastic, beautiful episode right here in the Garden of Paradise, aka also known as Back to Nature Organic Farms. It's a beautiful day to be alive. I'm happy to be living and happy to come back here and connect with the community and with the family and bringing forth some more empowering, enlightening, uplifting information around how we produce food in a wholesome way, in a healthy way that gives us the vitality, that gives us the energy, that lets us operate at our peak, at our optimal potential. Thriving, not merely surviving. And so with that, we have a fantastic episode coming here today. But right before we get into our episode, you guys always know, we ask you to like, comment, share. If you haven't subscribed, please go ahead and subscribe. Join the family here in the community. Now, who are we, what we do? You know, we always start our episodes saying that the closer we are to nature, the more proximate we are to nature, the more whole, happy, at peace, at ease we are. The further we get away from nature and get into artificial living, the GMOs and the fake lifestyles and the fake news, right? We move and distance ourselves and isolate ourselves from nature. We get into a state of dis-ease, and that's the root word of disease. So we here at Back to Nature, and that's who and what we are, Back to Nature Africa, we inspire, motivate, encourage Kenyans, East Africans, and Africans, and beyond, to adopt more natural, holistic lifestyle approaches for maintaining health, because if you're healthy, nothing more you want to do than to maintain it, or if you've lost it, how to regain it. From living holistic lifestyles, integrated, harmonized, synchronized with Mother Nature herself, and all the principles that come with nature, air, water, the fire and light, oxygen, etc. And so with that, we're grateful once again being here, and we also want to say give thanks to the Almighty, Him herself, for gifting us with this precious thing called life. We do not take it for granted. It is a present. It is a gift. That's why I guess they call it the present. So we are coming forward with this beautiful episode, and I'm feeling a little elated here because I'm surrounded by something that's giving off such a very powerful aroma. It's almost, I can call it AromaTherapy. The aromatic fragrance that is in the air is beautiful. Why? Because we find ourselves smack dab in the middle of a field of lemongrass dreams. Right? A field of lemongrass dreams. We've been toiling away here for the last few seasons, tinkering around, sort of working with different herbs and seeing what herbs particularly work in open field, meaning not in a greenhouse. And the lemongrass has sort of been that marathon runner. It didn't sprint initially, but it's come on strong. And we're going to talk a little bit about how we have been able to propagate this lemongrass and the process they were going through to harvest it, pack it, and some of the specifications around that. So we're going to talk about this lemongrass today. I think that's going to be the title of this episode, Field of Lemongrass Dreams, right? So let me grab the camera and let's walk around this section of the farm, because I'm standing right smack, I don't know if you can see it in the background, right smack in the middle of our lemongrass patch here. And we're also going to be joined by the farm manager extraordinaire, none other than Musa Mugai, who you guys have seen in previous episodes. We'll be having a chat and a walk around this particular area and what we're doing with the lemongrass, and going actually to our grading shed and seeing how we're going through and grading and adjusting the lemongrass to specifications, packing, etc. So let me grab the camera and let's get started with this today's with our episode today. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and here comes Mr. Mungai, right here in this beautiful, beautiful rows and rows field of dreams of lemongrass. Mr. Mungai, the lemongrass is almost half as tall as you and I here today, huh? How are you doing today, sir?
Greetings, everyone.
Excellent, excellent.
Yes, yes.
Very good. Well, thank you for joining us here for another episode. I think the Back to Nature family is getting used to seeing you. And since we're working a lot more closer and we're going to be doing some expansion on the farm, they'll be seeing you a lot more often. Nonetheless, we want to focus on here today, Mr. Mungai, on what we are right in the midst of. And so, if you don't mind sort of just introducing this aspect of lemongrass, and then we'll go into how is lemongrass planted, how is lemongrass sort of propagated and sustained, the nutrition, the watering, etc. And then when it's ready to be harvested, how do we know the time for harvest, how is the harvesting process, and then we'll move over to the grading shed. So if you don't mind sort of introducing us and take us to the process.
Yes. So lemongrass is a herb, actually. It's one of the many herbs which are grown.
Which has medicinal
It has
properties.
A lot of medicinal value.
Okay.
Especially when it is taken in drinks. This is the sucker.
That's the sucker.
This is the propagating material.
Okay.
Which we plant. You have to creep all this during planting.
Okay.
This is, after creeping those ones, this will allow.
Yes.
Or this will prevent a lot of water loss.
Okay.
So this in itself is a planting material. So first of all, you prepare your ground.
Okay. And now we're not in a prepared ground now because we're here full,
yeah.
But nonetheless, so yes, we can speak through it.
You make beds.
Okay.
And prepare 60 by 60 centimeter holes.
Okay.
Then you plant this one in every hole.
In every hole.
In every hole.
60 by 60 centimeters.
60 by 60 by 60 centimeters. Oh. This is one bed all along.
Okay.
Make 60 by 60 by 60 by 60 holes.
Yes.
Then you plant this one.
Now, once it's planted,
yeah.
What are some of the requirements that it will need in regards to nutrients and water? Is it affected by a lot of pests and diseases? Does it, as a, you know, with those properties that it has, does it, expel or push away pests and diseases? So sort of give us a little explanation.
Okay. So after you have prepared your beds,
yes.
Make holes, you have to add well-decomposed manure.
Okay.
Well-decomposed manure, then you plant. After planting, if it's not raining,
yes.
You must irrigate. Ah. If it's raining, this is a very hardy crop.
So, funny enough, we had not irrigated this section. We had not put down any drip irrigation because it was a trial, a research and development, and sort of seeing. But
we planted during the rainy season.
Rain season.
And it just picked up.
It had a chance to pick up because we did add the bolea, the manure, the compost, and got a chance to make sure we gave it the necessary nutrients.
Yeah.
Is it a heavy feeder? Is it something that can be intercropped with other?
It is a heavy feeder.
Okay.
So initially, once you have applied manure in the planting holes,
yes,
you have to keep on adding manure.
Okay.
Top dressing with manure and incorporating with the soil.
With the soil.
It's a heavy feeder.
Okay.
Once you do that, it grows vigorously, as you can see.
Yes. Now, the funny thing is, when you plant one single sucker like this, by the 60 by 60 by 60 as we talked about, all of a sudden, how does it start to replicate and multiply? Okay, in the lemongrass patch here in our herbal section, we had some slight difficulty, technical difficulties with the camera and some of the memory. But rolling here again, and we were just showing how we end up harvesting certain sections here in terms of the lemongrass. And once that harvest is able to come out, we're then able to, you know, section off the different parts of the lemongrass and begin the process of early sorting. And the sorting will allow us to determine the different sizes and the quality that we will then prepare and take over to our makeshift laboratory here, which is our grading shed. So just walking through our section here that contains, and by the way, these are some of the older cuttings that we take from the lemongrass that we've put here into our compost pit. Some of them will go to making other pieces or components that we will have as tea, but specifically what the market is requiring and the market desires are what we will call lemongrass splits. And these lemongrass splits are then cut into certain centimeters, a certain length, a certain width. And with that, that's what's going on right here. And you'll see Mr. Mugai and some of the team members here grading and having a chance to pack into the different boxes these lemongrass splits. So once you remove the top leaves, once you have a chance to remove some of the roots, then there's some hygiene and cleansing that goes on in terms of clipping. And these then are your lemongrass splits that we have there. As you see, a little bit of that process that is taking place in regards to making sure that we're keeping them a uniform, standardized size and clean cut, structured right, to make sure that we're then able to pack these lemongrass. And they usually come in these boxes here, which are 3 kilogram boxes. They're usually packed in a red liner bag, blue bag here, that then is supported by some short papers here that keep the moisture going. And then we will pack about 10 of them per bunch, and then with the bunch, about eight or nine of them will make 3 kilograms. Okay, Mr. Mugai, as we're wrapping up here, you want to quickly sort of mention how this process has ended up once we've gone from where we were in terms of the harvesting. We brought them here to the grading shed, had a chance to grade them, have a chance to cut them to make sure that they are uniform size, and then from there, the packing, and then we can go ahead and wrap up with our lemongrass heaven show here, episode today.
So right from harvesting, we harvest sprigs like this one.
Yes.
We remove the leaves.
So what's desired by the market from the splits are not necessarily the leaves, even though the leaves do have good medicinal benefits, but it's the stock of the lemongrass is what the market is desiring and requires.
This is what we are achieving to get.
Okay.
Yeah. You have to make it as smooth as possible. Okay.
And And the uniform sizes that they'll usually take is anywhere between 22 to 27 centimeters in terms of
this,
length.
This one has to be between 22 and 27 centimeters. The diameter has to be thick. Just this is just good.
Okay.
So you make a clean cut, the upper side and the lower side, a smooth cut. Make sure it's clean.
Yes.
Then from there you come with a bleach. This is water containing a bleach.
Yes, an organic base. Just disinfectant there.
Yeah. After wiping, then you grade, you pack them together. Each pack contains about 10 sticks. These are 10. Then you come and pack. This is a 3 kg carton. Each carton will contain about 8 to 9 bunches.
Okay.
You pack. Underneath you have placed a white paper to absorb moisture.
And actually I grabbed one from there.
Yeah. Then on top you place another piece of paper. The purpose is to absorb moisture.
Yeah, and to keep the moisture as well.
Yeah. Then you wrap very carefully.
Okay, so there we go. As it says there, fresh herbs, produce of Kenya. And with that, this is lemongrass, something that is highly beneficial, has the medicinal properties that are very healing, good for the gut, good for many different health reasons, and it's an interesting demand. Not only locally but internationally as well, export markets that are quite interesting. So thank you, Mr. Mungai, for getting a chance to share this here today. And we want to thank all the participants here at the Back to Nature, you know, community and family who are contributing. This farm, this enterprise, what we have going on here would be nothing without all the team and all the contributors that are assisting. So this was our episode here. Any last words about lemongrass, sir?
Lemongrass, it's good to farm lemongrass. It has a lot of medicinal properties. And now we are heading to the factory.
Absolutely. We're taking there to make sure that we get a return on the investment and all the time and energy to make it happen. So this has been our small makeshift grading shed here, small little operation that we look to extend.